fast as the wind. I missed the boss room again. The mini-map is just not very noticeable. Intruder alert, or whatever. This is an opportunity to test the power of my thunderbolts. You, come here for a minute. Can I not? And... oh, I got zapped. No! I do like those little, like, quest-oriented, dialogues. Those are pretty cool. You get to, like, see the anime versions. Since I think this game is also, like, some sort of something. I don't want to say anything. It might be a comic. Oh, come on. Thank you! And there's like the whole cool slow motion thing when you kill him. And each boss dies in their own way, too. And Gabriel is like a random occurrence where you can... it's a different shopkeeper and you can just buy stuff from him that you wouldn't ordinarily be able to get. He usually sells like pots and... what else does he usually sell? Like, occasionally he sells rare pieces of equipment. Like, see, a mage potion, then a fighter potion. But, you know, I'm a slayer, so I'm never gonna get anything for the slayer class. Back to town, and he rides it. He's like a priest that rides a dragon or something. Weird like that. You know, whatevs. I'll complete this quest. I completed all three of them. I get a stick. Thanks. Thanks, guy. Solid club. Oh, great. Now I have to go to the Poison Thunderlands. That's gonna be fun. He probably stole it, he probably didn't take it. I was like, oh yeah. Something strange is happening among the goblins lately. The number of mutant goblins has been increasing along with all the albino goblins. That's not normal at all. I'm completely baffled. Even a goblin can't figure it out. That's weird. We have to go talk to Sierra. I kinda wanna complete the other one. The Stigaves are the ones that have, like, those flags on their backs, and they carry, like, they're the red ones and the blue ones, and they throw fire and ice at you. Challenge box is just, it gives you random scrolls. So, see what we get from this pot, and if it's any good. Probably not. Use ring boots. And this challenge box just gives you a cosmos, an earth, and an abysmal scroll. Those are for a hell mode, which you'll unlock later on. Oh, they suck. I like the lightning guard better than the plantain ring. What? It's actually only better because... it only is better because it gives me light resistance. That's the only thing. Meh. Mystic is better, so I guess I'll use it. I'm tired of using a square sword. That makes no sense. Oh, hey guys, I got a square sword. Okay. So much for stabbing people. So, yeah. I can just click the sell button. Oh, that's the only annoying thing. It's like, all the stats for the item ever! It's like, no! Cut it out. And then this guy just gives you random challenges. I'll do these later. But I'll just accept them now. I'll do them when I'm not recording. So you guys don't have to watch me do the same dungeons over and over again. This game is very heavily grinding orientated. Wait, no, I don't want to do the Poison Thunderlands bet because it'll become activated when I, like, have to do the Poison Thunderlands. Which is not a very fun dungeon to do at all. Did I? Oh yeah, I got the challenge box. Never mind. Oh, and I didn't level, so we don't have anything to spend skill points on. The Poison Thunderland. Have you ever heard the sweet whispers of Lugaru? You can hear them when... You can hear them when Penrose's profound yet poisonous scent fills the air. Close your eyes, doesn't it all feel so peaceful? I love it how they all have, descriptions for the areas. And the reason why I have everything up to Master unlocked on this is because it's the shared difficulty thing. If you've beaten it on another character, they won't make you beat everything except for Master to get the next difficulty, because you have to be able to, you have to be ready to do King, I guess. So it kind of saves you a bit of time in regards to grinding, so you, because you have to get a certain rank to unlock the next rank of the dungeon. And these guys are like jumping you. The Fortune HP coins are a 50-50 chance that it'll either heal you or harm you. I love this, like a shockwave. It's like, get pulled. No, no way. I don't want to pick up the loot. Stop on attacking things. This game makes grinding fun, and not a whole lot more fun than it would be normally. Oh, there's no one there. Oh, and that stuff, it hurts. There's actually status effects or status debuffs that you can get from the environment. Like, these pools of poison, it'll actually, like, hurt you for a second while you're standing in. I thought it would, at least. Oh, no, I'm frozen! And then you have to button mash to help reduce the time of the status ailment. Like, sometimes if you're stunned, they'll make you smash buttons to get unstunned from an enemy attack. These are the mutant ones, I guess. You get Rayan Cokes for defeating them, and what those do is, if you take them to the gunner lady that you'll eventually have to talk to, then she'll reinforce your weapons, which I guess adds special, like, stabbers to the weapons, making them better. But you have to pay a lot of money, the higher level it is. Like, on my mage or whatever, I tried to get it reinforced. It only takes one Rayan Coke to make it a plus one, but it costs like 35,000 gold because it was a level 55 item. They're like, oh, you know, you make 20-30k a dungeon just by selling all the equips that you get that you don't need and all the loot that the monster drops. I didn't really have a whole lot of money since I'd spent it buying other stuff. I think I have the super armor buff now, which means I guess you take a whole lot less damage and you're still awesome. Unstoppable. Name Unstoppable. Rod Unstoppable. This growl attack is really annoying because it stuns you. I don't know who Ron Stoppable is. Oh my god. That was one of the main things that I used to watch on TV. I didn't really watch a whole lot of Nickelodeon or anything. I mainly watched, like, Disney and PBS. Kind of interesting back when Disney wasn't awful. Missing that. I do like that double uppercut. Did I?
I'm gonna beat you with my stick.
Sounds weird. Oh, this still really doesn't make any sense. How I keep, like, missing slash hitting them. I think this goop stuff just makes you walk slower and makes you move slower in general, I guess. I don't know. So we're almost to the boss room. These flowing benefits of burning blitz points. All stats plus 50. Wait, what? I don't know what burning blitz is. Is that like that goop? I don't know what that is. Make it go away. Ow. I don't want thief weapons and I don't want to get pelted here. Stun the unbeliever! Stun the unbeliever! Cannot defeat me in the power of Sticky Stick. I'm sorry if I don't seem as high energy today. It's kind of later in the day, so I'm childish and not motivated. I've kind of been playing video games all day. Or not all day. I've been watching videos all day, so kind of like, yeah, no. And I haven't had the most mentally engaging day. What's the boss room? I kind of forgot. Oh, I hate that. The bosses stand up and it's like, oh, you're stunned. You can't do jack squat. Heck, it looked kind of derpy just like throwing the stick out and like shockwave. It's a stick. It's not the most intimidating thing in the world. Oh well, at least I get a katana now. But I think you have to be a blade master to be proficient in katanas or some crap. Let me take a quick sip. Sweet. Arneb. What? It's a yellow totem pole with a face thing. That's the very nice totem pole you have there. Arneb Kunik totem pole. I guess it's a good thing. I don't really care. Because I'm not a priest. Back to town, see? Yeah, see? Why is my blitz yellow? I don't. Blitz on. Blitz on! I guess you get a bonus for the more blitz you use. I was in deep thought. Here, have this steel kotachi. Better than a stick. I'm pretty sure I've been running it on expert the whole time. Like, I haven't bothered with normal. Let's look at the character screen and see what strength does for slayers. Increases your physical attack strength. Strength of what? Poison, bleeding, burning, electrocution, stone, curse resistance. Intelligence is just magic. Oh well, I will spend my 30 quest points on vitality. So now I only have 10. I will equip. Oh, this is actually worse. It gives me strength and intelligence. Oh well, I'll equip it. I don't want to use a stick. Stick can go away. Why are all these people going pink? I'm so confused. I'm a demon. Oh, get on my level. It's kind of weird. I'll pedal the stick to the old man. Oh, I have to claim my spoils of war. Pet food. Oh my gosh. No, it's Potion of the Soul. It reduces cooldown time for skills for 60 seconds. Minus 10. Should use these pots. See what we get from leather armor! Nothing good. Heck, what? Yep. Generic crap. And this is gonna be some stupid thief item. Makeshift Karka Jin Dagger. What? I'm seriously glowing pink. It's the demon aura. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Probably not gonna make these episodes as long as the first one. That was just sort of a, hey, look at me. I'm playing DFO. This one's sort of like 15-minute bits of goodiness. Goodness, not goodiness. Oh, wait.
What?
Thunderland bet. I'm not gonna do that. I don't want to do it on King. So in this one, you have to fight this chick, and she's all like, I can summon us. And I'm like, cool story, bro. How about an expert? Just cause. Just cause two. La 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 la. Sounded really stupid. This makes more sense. Like, you can stab someone with the pointy end of this thing, not like, oh, you brute, taste the blunt end of my square. Confusion. Though the annoying thing is, like, when you get a job advancement, it doesn't change your character's sprite that to accurately reflect the class. It's just the same sprite, so I guess that's an incentive to buy an avatar. But buy this and your character won't look as little. Does that have faster attack speed? But it's still got a crappy combo. It's got a wider, like, splash radius. I am the way of the samurai. Samurai Jack, oh my gosh. Never saw that a whole lot, but when I did watch it, it was just like, this is amazing. Had a really cool art style, and it was just, in general, awesome to watch. Cause I was that big bad guy, and he had to go back in time, and it's like, just slicing everything up. Kinda reminds me of, oh gosh, it's a top guard. Nope. Kinda overkill that guy, and just spamming skills on him. That's how I roll. Gardener lol. Those things like some plants. Ooh, that's a nice combo. If only, like, the amazing thing about this game is you can just juggle mob enemies. What? Hi. Stupid thing. Weird cat from hell. Like a bat out of hell, I'll be gone before the morning comes. How is that missing? Oh, because you're a mutant. Gotcha. Go join the X-Men, freak. Boom! Boom! These skills are gratifying. You're just like, I'm totally dominating, and you can feel it too. You're just like, domination! And then some of the skills you get after your class advancement are just amazing. They just wreck shop. I can't believe they all missed him. No! I accidentally went down. Boom! Oh, it's a mutant Tau Guard. Come at me, bro. And they have these annoying shields that makes that ding 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 noise. Oh, wait, I don't know. D is Z. That D is Z. I don't need that on my skill bar either. Dull Amund. Oh, it's like a stick. Yeah, your green stick. I'm so proud. Didn't really say how he got possessed by a demon. He just, like, killed his family and then he got possessed by a demon. Or, like, he possessed a demon and the demon made him kill his family. Which is thoroughly disturbing. Everybody else's stories, I think, are slightly less grim. Like, the male mages, whatever is, like, he got killed in battle and he went to hell. Or, no, like, he died and he went to hell and then, I guess what you would call Satan or whatever was, like, you've led an immoral life or whatever, and that's not something you should be proud of, or something to the effect of, hey, that's not a good idea. And then he took his heart and made him go back as a heartless creature, and then he gave